Hello, it's Ian Michael here. And today we're going to be looking at Aliens vs. Predator. I've completely revamped this, and I have made the intros to look like the Sega CD, the old-fashioned full-motion video on the Sega CD. As you can see, right here, one of my favorite famous catchphrases, as you can see. Now, I've replicated how full motion video works on the Sega CD. This is the full intro from the arcade machine. I have completely remixed the levels and made sure they work. You have 6 levels, and the game has been reimagined. I have a new boss, more elevator action, going up, going down. It is now a 4-player game, so you can play 4 players at once now. It was only ever a 1-player game. We'll watch the intro here. So this is my version of simulation. So, this is a complete game. It works from CDR and GDEMU. As you can see, it's the full intro from the arcade machine. So, now we're on to Dream Boar, Aliens vs. Predator, Aftermath X. So, let's look at the new selection. You've got Dreamcast Arcade, you've got the BIOS, sound test I didn't do, it's not really well. You've got level 5 boss to end, you've got level 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the ending. Now, the ending is also in Sega CD full motion video, the full ending. So let's just start and play from beginning to end on the arcade mode. Before we do that, yeah, this is the BIOS selector that tells you about the players. It's from the arcade machine. So, let's get out of this. Let's start the game. And let's have a little playthrough here. Show you what I've done. We'll start with the Predator. I have Sega CD-like level screens for every level. I just say level 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The enemies now have varied hit bars, how much energy they use. You also have the eggs on level 1. Forward, forward. Forward, forward, and the button is your special predator move. Let's get rid of this egg. All right, so I've also remixed the music on several stages so that you can hear it. Also now have a Royal Guard at the end of this level. play this from beginning to end. I'm not going to spoil all of it for you. I will play. Show you that. There's the Royal Guard. First level boss. So stage one is complete. This is the new level that I put in. Coming through that door, you come out to on top of the building. Street. Run up. There. Could have made it more coherent and made it go up the elevator first. This game was completely broken from the original creator. After the first level, it would reboot on the Dreamcast and it was completely unusable. I've now made it a full game. With 6 levels, including the end boss level. Of course, your super move, but it also takes your own energy when you get rushed, is your Y button. Like now, might as well press it. I have them rushing you a lot on the patterns. That's stage 2 complete. Level 2. See some new enemies and sprites. Comes fast and furious. Very good frame rate, 60 frames a second, just about. And the new Dream Speech Rage Engine Dreamboard. Guaranteed when you download my versions of these open world games that they will be finishable and completable and will boot on your Dreamcast. If they do not boot on your Dreamcast, you do not know how to burn images. Your hardware is faulty, as I have put the effort in and time to burn each one, so you don't have to. Of course, you can play this on any of the Eliminator sorts. The Dream Shell SD ISOs will follow, but they're not my priority since I think that an unmodified console should be able to play the release first. And it's only a matter of using ISO make tools to make the versions of these and unscramble the first bin. If you unscramble the Dream Ball bin, we go on to level 3, then it'll work on that. Now here's the first elevator section. This is not a particularly long game. play till I run out of credits. Whatever comes first, I either finish the game or I run out of credits. So. You can fall off the elevator. So we're going down into the bowels of the city now. We'll make sure to choose another character next time. Credit to the original author for ripping the sprites. They move and emanate in such a nice fashion. I've just seen on the forum people saying they have burned other people's versions of these Dream Ball games and they just hang in their own boot. Well, that's because Magnuson has hex edited the bin, so it only works and loads the ID. It loads on the hard drive on Dream Shell. So if you please do not burn those images, please. They do not work or boot on a GDEMU. Because something works on an Eliminator does not mean it works on real hardware. You should have seen when I got bitten by that at Christmas with Jazzy Jackrabbit, the Christmas version, which works perfect on Eliminators and doesn't boot at all on hardware. Same can be said for the Dreamcast Media Center, which you can watch all the movies to your heart's content on an old DC, but on real hardware, it'll play the movie, but the sound will skip all over the place. Okay. Taking this elevator ride to get down to where the Queen is. So you know, forward, 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 forward. Alright. Forward, 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 forward is your special move. Jump in midair, that is your super kick. So, we're moving on. Stage 4 is complete. Okay, let's she can actually shoot with the forward forward. Show you forward forward. She can also do a Hadouken energy blare. She can also get the hunter. He also has his, it's like boomerang slicing thing. I to the next stage. Which five do you think? Which is level 4. So you can now play this with 4 players. Try to get the highest score, post your scores on all these games. There we go. Moving on to the next stage. Stage 6 complete. Is level 5. We're now going up a level. You enjoyed the effort this took to make a complete game and playable experience. I'm just about 5 hours into development to turn this from a broken demo into a playable experience, a structured game. Credits left, and it is a hell of a long way up. We went down a long way, but we're going to the Queen's Nest. So we're on the way to the Queen's Nest. See there, I just got taken out there. We will eventually reach the location. One credit left. Sorry if I sound so tired and burned out, but this this actually took longer than I thought it would take to dev into a full game, since it only came as a demo with a couple of levels. And it's completely broken. This is using the new DreamBore 6.5 optimized memory routines. Make sure to look at my plane files, which are always unpacked, to know how. So, there's stage 7 complete. Now we're into the boss final. Put some effort into the last stage to make it look a little better, work a little better. This is the Queen's eggs. As you can see, here's the queen. There's one of those chest busters. Right. I'm getting rid of the old queen over here. I may revisit this at a particular point. Make it a little bit more coherent, probably. I'm not promising anything because there is a lot of games to go through. So that's completing the game. Just on about 24 minutes. Look for a quick play with your mates. Now we're going to see the simulated Sega CD . So let's see the simulated Sega CD ending. Thanks for playing, everyone. Hope you enjoy this new remixed version of Aliens vs. Predator. Now let's watch the ending. This is the Sega CD simulated full motion video. Ending to the game. This is the full arcade ending. From the arcade. Simulated in full motion video, Sega CD style. I hope you enjoyed the presentation. This is Ian Michael signing out. Thank you very much. Download link is in the description. And this concludes Alien vs. Predator Dream Boar Edition. As you can see, we can play through the entire game with enough memory to spare. We'll go and look how much memory is left after all that. And as you can see, if you create the game properly, there's still over 7 meg of memory that we could add to this game. Alright, see you in a future video. Farewell.